Tchuinkou, Kwadjo. Today I'm going to present to you our work, which is titled Automatic Assessment of Infant Sleep Safety Using Video-Based IoT for SUID Prevention. So, every year in the US, more than 4,000 infants die annually for sleep-related causes. The pediatrician recommend direct observation. However, this can be really costly, time-consuming, invasive, and poor. This table presents all the criteria that must be assessed in order for a sleep environment to be safe. This concerns some other the sleep space, the sleep position. In this work, we intend to develop a model that is able to identify and classify those criteria. We currently develop a model to assess the sleep environment using semantic segmentation. In order to be able to train that model, we build a data set where each image will independently assess it to code a variability across five different domains, which are the location, the surface, the position, and the presence of items in the sleep area. We manually label each pixel of in every image according to the color it belongs to for one of the criteria. However, as we move forward, we realize that model the sleep environment is not enough to prevent SUID. We also need to be able to track the vital sign of the baby. To detect vital signs, we use an approach called euclidian video magnification, or EVM, that has been developed by an MIT lab since 2012. The purpose of this approach is to amplify sudden movements, such as chest movement when somebody is breathing. We can then compare the pixel variation differences in frames over time for breathing detection. The current picture presents the overview of our system. The system is being implemented on an FPGA board called Ultra 96. We have a camera that is connected to an MIPI IP that is an interface to stream the image from the camera to the Zing Ultra Scale multiprocessor system on chip. This processor hosts a 64-bit ARM Cortex processor infused with programmable logic. The video pipeline on the programmable logic receive image frames on the processor. Within the programmable logic, image data is transmitted through an axing stream bus. With resources constrained on the device, the inference model, which is supposed to perform the semantic segmentation, is accelerated on the programmable logic, and the EVM is implemented on the processor. Information are relayed into the cloud by the MQTT client. An event is triggered when the instructed knowledge from the stream is critical. In the framework, each image is recorded to a broker as a topic and the caregiver or any authorized third party are the subscribers. With both algorithms running in our system, we can then classify the environment as safe when no critical event is detected. We send a warning notification when a criterion from the safe environment is not respected with at least 70% of accuracy with positive vital sign response, which means the baby might be in danger but is still breathing. And we send a critical notification when there is no a breathing response. That means after tracking the vital sign between a consecutive frame within a second and we don't detect any change, then we send the critical notification. The table below presents the average accuracy of the different criteria of the baby sleep environment. As we can observe, this criterion still doesn't meet the state of the art in terms of semantic segmentation algorithm. This is mainly because we're still building our data set, especially for baby sleep environment. Image are really difficult to acquire because of the privacy. Another result here, we presented the pixel variation over time when the baby is breathing. As you can see, we can observe the variation, which is consistent over time, meaning that there is some activity within the sleep environment of the baby. However, when there is no activity, which means we assume that there is no, as we can observe, we can see that the variation is mostly constant. This relates to a critical situation because there is currently no activity in the sleep environment. We then reach the end of our presentation. As conclusion, we present a framework to prevent SUID by combining semantic segmentation to model the sleep environment and EVM to detect vital signs. However, this approach at its current state cannot be used for real-time application because it takes approximately 124 milliseconds to process each frame. So this will lead to an average of 8 frames per second, which does not qualify for which that real-time application. In the future, we intend to increase the size of data set. This will help to also improve the overall accuracy of our semantic segmentation model. We also intend to present a more efficient implementation of the EVM algorithm to improve the overall execution time. Thank you.